decided I'll do this first, quickly. First, because I wanted to... No, pop up. But I just want to, like, talk about, like, I just want to play, talk. I don't really want to, like... Like, I don't want to... If you guys don't know, check out my last episode. It was, like, a two-hour episode. What I did is I went through and I made my... I decided to relocate the Tampa Bay Buccaneers as the London Monarchs. Moving to London, I think we chose... I think I chose Deluxe. I know it was a Deluxe. I think it was a Deluxe Futuristic Stadium. Because I wanted to, like, bring, like, a futuristic type of stadium. I wanted to see if I could try to use, the other stadium that's already in London. There's a stadium in London they play, like, London games in. Who's this person? Oh, this is Alfred Lewis and Fred Jackson. Doesn't know. Sorry about this, why I'm not negotiating with him. So I'm waiting between him, between Fred Jackson and, I have another, halfback named, Alfred Blue, who did a fantasy draft. He's an Alfred Blue and Fred Jackson, that's on my, I put Dominic Brown, or, yeah, there's his name. He's just sitting there, just like, or just sitting there. Who's my third down running back? I think I might make Fred Jackson my third down running back. And release Dominic Brown. I'll use him as trade bait. Trade bait! Yes! 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 Oh, I just got it. I just did myself a greatest idea. Trade bait. 75 overall halfback. Some teams would kill to have this. This is what we're gonna start off the live stream with. Okay, we need defensive tackles. Let's put a trade block. Defensive tackles. Really? And an all button. Not only an all button. I found somebody that needs a hat. Or that, like, yeah. This is gonna take a while. I was loud the other day. I really hope this idea was good. Offer them a halfback. Offer them Donald Brown. You want my wide receivers? I'll draft a wide receiver. I'll from no. Humphries. Really? Okay. That improves my, you know, my position a little bit. I'm gonna go out and sign for free agents. Sign a wide receiver free agent. Any good ones out there? Possession. That means I'm gonna keep my first how it is now. So if he, and also if you guys get to my last episode, I'm gonna be screwed if Hunter gets hurt though. Then so, yeah. Or I can move right there. I'd be careful on throwing him in. Okay. So that's what I was saying. Oh, he's a fullback. Oh, wait, that's not good. Oh, so now I don't even have, okay, so I don't have a fourth string, which is important because I don't really need a fourth string. Okay, so back to what I was saying. So if you listen to again my last episode, I traded up for some picks. A couple of picks too. I scouted a few different college players. Now I'm gonna go to some wide receivers. Look at this. This dude is somebody I want to get. He's an early first rounder too. Look at my different picks. Projected pick, first round, first. Oh wait, it's the first? How the heck did that happen? Round 1, 10, round 1, 12. I have three different round one picks. I'm kind of happy about. This dude is the one I want. Red zone threat. He's from LSU. He's got A- spectacular catch, B+ catching traffic, and him catching. I'm kind of sad that his juke moves and stuff isn't on there, like spin moves and stuff like that. Oh, he's a red. I was gonna say his speed wasn't on. That's what I was saying. I really wanted speed. I mean, he's not a speed, he's a red zone threat. This dude's speed. I might wait for him. Okay. I might get him second round if I have a pick. For a 6'5". Let me see. And then second round. Good. I might look for you in my third or my pick. Charleston Southern. Hey, dude. Ooh, I need a route runner. I don't really need a route runner. I know a lot of my friends, whenever they play, they're really good route runners. Mostly because we play a lot of, oh wow, there's a lot of different quarterbacks going on. Flores. Dang. Should I go and draft a younger quarterback? Yo. Is undrafted talent? Dude, Max Sanchez from Clemson. Oh, he's probably meant to represent, wait a second. These are all meant to represent actual quarterbacks going into the draft. Wait a second. Okay. Some of these people are actually meant to represent actual, like, people. Where's the halfback that I saw? Speedback from Florida, though. But, I mean, wow, that's Clemson, he's probably meant to represent Scott Lambert, Ole Miss, Florida State. That's for, what's his face? I mean, you gotta have a 4 to stay in the top 10. If you don't have a 4 to stay in the top 10, it's not really a good draft. LSU, here we go. Clemson. I'm rejecting everyone, but should be this guy. He's got first round talent. How are they gonna pick him? What does he have? Mid to early? Let me go watch. Only one person that's like bad. Like be hit however you can shoot. You know what, it's been like 11 minutes. Let's actually play a game now. Oh, I got Philip Rivers back. I'm so excited. Oh, I'm literally like happy. I play all offensive snaps. I'm really a big offensive player. I don't really like to play the defense unless I play like this is just fun. Unless I play like a certain player, but and next week after this, which I will be playing in the sledge room, is my Thursday game, which is the game Thursday primetime, which is Color Rush, and I'm playing, I believe, the Falcons. Excited. Imagine like my last game in because after this year I move. I'm not moving like now, but I'm moving like next week. My last game in Tampa Bay. Raymond Jones gonna be my last game. Oh, it's gonna be so sad.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley.
Sad thing is that it was low enough to actually relocate. I mean, that's just
live action. Let's see what this offense can do here on this play.
And everybody else is all just like, why are they leaving? Well, I mean, it's an 18-year-old stadium that, I mean, has a horrible rating, too.
Fitzgerald's got it right side. It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll make it second down.
I'm kind of glad that I relocated. Mostly because it would kind of like make it different. Like I know, like a bunch of
tailbacks. And he stopped immediately there. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
I know a bunch of different teams over here have relocated there.
And he'll take this one only up to about the 21. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. NFL teams last year, a little under 50% on fourth down conversions. This is a bit tougher. Fourth and 4. And he finds Fitzgerald. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. Back out there now. Let's see what they can put together. And Tampa Bay trots out there now.
Look at my boots.
And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football?
Oh, no!
Offense take care of the defense. Defense take care of the offense.
Okay.
That didn't
happen
on the last possession.
I was almost
back up and help their team.
Shallow cross. And I don't really know what.
There's no shyness there pushing the ball downfield, but I like the coverage on the play in good position. And when you're
like
50
lay down, but that like messes up my
come down with it. I like the way they made the play, came across and knocked it away.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
Oh, I like that. That's a good
marker. Is down here.
Like
and he's brought down.
Boy, you didn't have to do that.
Still second down.
So that last play called back after the penalty, second and long here. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Rivers now on second down. Caught on the left side, Fitzgerald. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First down coming there on the intermediate passing play. That's been a point of emphasis, they told us in practice, using those medium routes to keep the defense off balance.
And it wasn't just them telling us. We got to watch them practice it and work on it because they've been trying to fine-tune it and get it right before this game. And I think they have to be happy with the result.
Call it a pickup of seven, and that'll make it a second down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
Now a run. This is Alfred Blue. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It goes again to six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
Some teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football. In that situation, that's almost a tendency breaker.
They come up in an offset eye. Back to the ground. This time it's Peterson. He chucks him aside.
Dumped him.
Past the 20. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Adrian Peterson, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And on his way to the end zone, shedding the tackle, he would not be denied.
We don't
That's
talk
called
about
finishing the run. Making sure you power your way through.
He might take me down if I don't.
Offense back on the field here. Let's see what they can do on this play. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play. And that's how they got it done.
Yeah, and they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. A hit as he throws there. Incomplete. Trying to go back to Matthews there. And it'll be second and 10.
And deep, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. The first time Pro Bowler a year ago, Everson Griffin, in there to get him. And that's sack number six for him on the year. So a big sack on second down. Now let's see what the offense has in store for third. From the gun, Rivers. Looking deep downfield.
What the heck?
A big gain of 38 there on third down.
I know they had good coverage downfield, but you have to wonder, on third and long like that, how does that happen that they can get that far downfield and complete a pass? You got to guard the sticks, understand where you are, so it's almost like someone fell asleep at the switch. And now that the play's been completed, they've got to dust themselves off on defense, pick it up, and figure out how to not let that happen again.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. He lost two there, and it's third down. And they've got an extra defensive back out there now on third and 13. Throwing, Rivers. And it's complete. Henry.
Yo, I got like some great wide receivers going
on
here.
When the big guy runs a corner route, you're asking a lot no matter who's covering him. Doesn't matter whether it's a linebacker or a defensive back. Yeah. He usually has the advantage because of his body
between.
Type.
And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout.
Either Matthews or Fitzgerald. I think
a first down throw here for Rivers. There jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
I mean, their control's already the best
all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it in the end zone, a big-time drop.
A second down throw for Rivers.
Why did I press that button?
That's complete to his running back.
End
zone, touchdown, Buccaneers. Adrian Peterson with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Didn't have any
down field, swung it out to the flat, and did the rest. And jump into the end zone.
I believe we can. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush. Lose the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the ball.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here.
What happens when you run?
I had a coach tell me a long time ago that running a screen pass is similar to acting 101 for your offense, because you got to show something different and create extra space for linemen to chase the quarterback in order to create extra room for the receiver to catch the football and maneuver the field. In this case, they'll give a lot of credit to the defense. They communicated well. You hear them talking to each other on the field, and they reacted and knocked it away.
Sets up a first
and goal.
Every guy that plays this game has plenty of people around him that are concerned for his health and well-being.
Should I run it in?
He had no regard for his body on that catch at all, did he?
Middle of the field, diving to grab it. No, he didn't. Now Rivers.
Oh, could be Evan Gordon.
Flushed out right. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the 2.
Who's getting the ball?
Now whistles come in. We're going to get...
Who's getting the ball? Let me check. By the way, this is a clever way to check who's getting the ball. Oh, I'll get it down here, though. Game stats, maybe. Is it game stats? Oh, scoring summary. Here we go. No, it wouldn't be it. I'm trying to find out who got the ball first. You know what? I'm going to go risk, and I'm going to say
by the offense
that they got the ball first.
So as they take it over, we step aside. And Hauschka's kick is good. And that will do it for this first half.
Yes, we did get the ball back.
The offense back out there now. Let's see what they can put together.
If I mess that up, I don't get the field goal, and I don't get a touchdown there. That might have, like, nothing.
The third quarter starts with a run by Peterson. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line.
Man.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line.
Peterson. You have gotten, like, the second round of the draft.
Again, Peterson. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost 4 there, and it's third down.
You got ran too far out.
And the Raiders call on a nickel set for third down. To throw is Rivers.
Oh, no! Why did I press
left
that button?
Caught by Matthews. Just a 1-yard pickup on the play. Rivers is going to stay out
Why
there.
Why did I press that button?
They're going to try for this thing on fourth down. They're indeed going for it. It's Rivers. And this is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. It's back on the field here. Let's see what they can do on this play. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And last time we saw them go for it in kind of an unusual situation. It's not like it's a fourth quarter do or die. They went for it, didn't get it. We'll see how that affects them this go around.
Partner, I'm wondering if we're starting to see the effects of analytics coming into play here, where people are studying the number of possessions, how many times you should go for it, what position.
And nowhere to get it. Rivers is dropped. The former first round pick from Boise State, side linebacker, drops him for a loss of 6. And they'll add a DB in the secondary here on 3rd and 14. Rivers.
No!
Incomplete. Oh, let's see what this offense can do here on this play. And now the Buccaneers offense gets set to head back onto the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. A good pickup there, 26 yards. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator is looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's. That's exactly what they did there.
The whole group of Raiders there that time helped bring him down. And quickly, they get to the line.
He's done it multiple times before, but I'm not going to like.
Now they'll run it on the toss.
Woo!
And he is going to lose yardage here.
There was no area to go. Losing three.
And now it's third down. So third and seven and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
Rivers to throw it. Hits his target, Hunter. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie,
I think it's
you enter the danger
the reason
zone,
I'm
you
not like
to blitz him because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play,
down?
He can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
Oh, no.
And the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary
target.
No, time.
I thought I caught it.
I think he had to read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target.
The amount of
really
times
nice
I throw it down
second down here after the incomplete pass.
I haven't gotten
sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt
that
to
I've
get
played
a big
in
one
long
downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
What? Big play that time on the catch and run. 36 yards.
What are those?
They're going to hurry back to the line now. First and goal from the five. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here.
That was Alpha Blue.
Back now in Tampa. It's Buccaneer football, but they've got work to do. They find themselves behind here to start the fourth quarter.
Fan decision. That's the one thing I'll let the fans decide.
Rivers now on second down.
People that are still fans, like, you got a touchdown.
Look at that booty though.
Leaving all that sunlight.
The lead here in the
did he catch it? Yeah, both of them.
Offense back out there now. Let's see what they can put together. Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people. Now look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowl.
That really bad play.
Back on the field here. Let's see what they can do on this play. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and then sling another one.
Back-to-back stops make it third and 10.
Ooh, I like this.
And now
this
they're in the hurry-up.
Interesting. that deep pass?
No, now it's a bootleg with Rivers. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football.
Passes and blocks.
They get 14 yards there and a first down.
Right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. To throw, Rivers.
No,
right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
But Brandon, sometimes I think when we watch games, we're actually watching a living museum because we're seeing the evolution of positions almost with each passing game. How about defensive ends nowadays and the way that they can run almost all the way across the field?
It is unbelievable, isn't it? I mean, they're so strong, but they're so lean, they can move so quick with those bodies.
It's almost unfair. You're supposed to be able to know where a defensive end is supposed to be on every play. These guys flash so quickly, you're not sure where they're going to end up.
These are men.
Third and long for Rivers.
He got it! He got it! He got it! He got it!
And the head coach reaches for the red flag, tosses it down on the field. He wants a challenge here.
I should have reviewed it first. Oh, crud. He's in. Does he have that foot already down, though? Does he have... I'm gonna finish it. Apparently, he didn't have the foot already down.
Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all...
He's got it! Hit the 15! Touchdown! Tampa!
Good! The speedster on the right hand side!
His first touchdown on the year!
What?
And the Bucs are gonna take the lead!
He put on the jet
wow,
the last second!
Wow, talk about a big fourth-down conversion for the score defensively. How do you let that happen?
You know, he's like letting him down.
I think you start with the offense, I throw it. And you give them credit for going for it, having that
like quickly.
Now, let's face it, audacity. Able to
reel it in and run it in for
his
target,
partner. There's no way
no,
something like that's supposed to happen in that situation.
Yes? Okay. Oh, my mic was fun. Sit for that. Okay. Oh, 223.
Let's see what okay, my goal here. This play. Now the Buccaneers offense gets ready to head
we're
back
down
onto
time.
The field.
We're down the
and
clock.
That last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack.
Oh, you know what?
Think
let's
that they
go
were because
for...
if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look good.
I want to run down that clock.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went. No adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
They only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and eight forthcoming. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll run it now out of the gun. Call it a gain of three, and it'll bring up fourth down. Time for a break.
Now I'm going to go.
We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. Now Rivers on fourth down, and it's complete. Henry.
Oh wow! I just made a touchdown on fourth down. Unless this dude pitches up a
touchdown, Tampa Bay. Connor Henry.
Wired to the wire. Oh, I thought it was gonna ask me if I wanted to go for two.
Fits back out there now. Let's see what they can put together. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. They have the lead. Still a one possession game, but the defense got the stop. They've got the football now. Just salted away, right?
Exactly.
In trouble in the ball. And the defense has got it. And this is recovered in the end zone for a touchdown. So they were down by a touchdown. Probably just.
What the heck just happened?
Let's see what they can do on this play. So out come the Bucks now.
Bumble.
They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. If they get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play, but if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that.
Offense.
Yeah, thanks. That was you! Your little booty jumped ahead! Alright. There's field goal range.
Here's Rivers.
Maybe if I hit field goal range early.
And his throw's gonna be incomplete.
Boy! I don't know what I'm doing.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Now Rivers. He's going to loft one deep left side.
Yes.
Here. He's got a man complete.
What the heck? What kind of?
Nice pickup of 33 yards.
There's obviously nothing shy about the guys dialing up offense here. They take a shot on third down, and boy, did they get rewarded.
So cool.
Even though.
Now whistles, and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
I'm running it. I'm going to run it. Punt. What would I punt? I've got two timeouts. This is my plan. Okay. So I've got two timeouts. Think about this. I've got two timeouts. As long as this doesn't go for like a bunch of yards. Okay, this is my plan. Very bad.
17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills? And it does it in so many different ways. In this case,
now the Raiders are going to use another timeout here. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So it's all going to come down to Steven Hauschka. He made his only attempt earlier. This for the win. And this one is right through. And it'll be a hot time and even tonight. The Bucks have won the football game. Still trying to digest the final moments of the game. What a fantastic drive to win it.
To see the winning team execute, stay calm and in the moment, and get it done, it really was a thing of beauty to conclude this game.
So for the Buccaneers, they move back over 500 now at 4-3. And they'll get to stay put for a few days as they'll host the Atlanta Falcons next week. Meanwhile, for the Raiders, they'll fall to 5-3 with a loss. And they'll have a tough one at home next week against the Denver Broncos. So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. And with that, I'm off to the airport. Charles will be on I-4 back to Windermere, as we say so long from Tampa.
Have a nice trip. I'll be home before you even take off.
Lucky.
Welcome. Well, that was an interesting game. Just view the okay. I just want to view the highlights. Okay. Isn't that like a highlight button where it just shows you all the highlights? It's all together. What was this for? Oh, that was the one for a touchdown. You have the 5-yard rush. And then where is it again? Oh, Cutler's on the Raiders. Wow. Respect Marshall. Huh? What is this? We're gonna go to a local football game. Go with my little sister. I think that'd be a good idea. Forever song. Wow. Hunter Henry. Hey, Hunter Henry. He's got like the Hunter spreads. It's kind of like anger, except it's Hunter. There's got to be something going on in the game. Besides our color rush game. Really? Like, nothing else? Have a media question? Dang. Laser pointer wouldn't have been more accurate. I mean, I got 66%. It's not like amazing. There's all like 70 overall players. Should I send Fred Jackson now? Should I put Red as my third down running back? Or should I put Alfred as third down? Oh my right. I'm just gonna check what the church. Defense. Is this what you're signing as a backup? I know some of these players, man. Oh. You look at injury report. Jeez, basically no offensive players. That's not bad. Complete MCL turn. Yeah. First of all, with a partial PCL turn. Yeah, that's gonna be a little bad. Andrews with a place there and broken tibia. Oh, yeah, that might be sick. You see this game going. Should we turn it right back? I wish there was kind of like a media, social media, for men 18, what they should do, should make a whole social media thing, so that way, like, you as, like, the owner of the player can, like, tune down or something. Something like that, you know? Like, kind of like what MLB did, like, where they have, like, the Twitter for the player, except for you control your Twitter. Kind of like with, NBA 2K16 and 17 for, like, the mobile app. And I think they also have it for the actual game. I haven't tested it out yet. But why'd I go in stadium? How are the fans happy? Our defensive backs are awesome. Okay. Merchandise prices are still too high. Oh, I forgot to put merchandise prices down. Oops. My team. Is it, maybe is it Eleanor? Maybe it's Mark. Is it Mark? Oh, that's a recent media question. It's part of my team. Is it my team? Is it in my coach maybe? Nope, it's just... Oh, trade center's locked. That's locked. Trade deadline. Was it in finances maybe? Oh, it wasn't finances. Why are tickets going down, man? Sweet, tickets are so cheap that we took the whole family. It was the half rush show. It was the half rush show. I put, if you guys didn't, in the last episode, I put ticket prices down for like a half off sale. Well, apparently it didn't go so well. Apparently, people like it. They're like $50. Whoa, 50 cents. 50 cents. 50 cents. Not $50, 50 cents. $8. Why are you even buying coffee? It's like they just start complaining about it. They don't like the turkey leg prices. Merchandise, look at that. Look at the merchandise though. Team revenue went up. Team revenue made $10.8 million last game. That's because it was a home game. That's cool. Wait, now I'm going to check because I haven't checked on this yet. Okay, it's good. See what my last game at Raymond Jones Stadium is. Last game against the Panthers. Sunday, 1 p.m. Oh, if I lose that, that's sad. Week 17. Thursday games. Okay, that's this week, I believe. Yes.
Prime time. We're in our nice.
Oh, wait, did I sign this video? Oh, okay.
Sorry, bro.
I'm gonna sign you too, because I'm gonna play. Well, you're not gonna play, though, because you're back. I just spent like $10. And it is color. Okay, let me just make sure we got jerseys. You guys will get confused.
Oh, I'm gonna get confused. Oh, this was a stupid idea. No! No, what have I just done? Oh, no. Oh, I just messed up. Oh, I really messed up. Oh, I really messed up. Oh, I'm not a big boy anymore. I need a boo-boo. I need a wheel boo-boo. I'm not a big boy anymore. Uh-oh. Guys, I think I made a boo-boo. A real big boo-boo. And this one's a big one. It's a real big one. This is a real big boo-boo. Real big boo-boo. So yeah, I accidentally made a red on accident today. This was a very stupid
Hello,
idea.
Everybody.
Very.
What's the word?
So unintelligent. Let's see what this offense can do here on this play.
How am I gonna be able to tell who's who? This is going to be the funnest thing ever.
One receiver left, three to the right.
This is going to be fun.
Interception here, Rivers. He gets it into the hands
of Larry
Fitzgerald. It'll be a gain of nine.
I'm playing defense.
It'll be second and about a yard.
Smash.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Stepping up, he's going to keep
he's
it, and he'll
he's
be taken
hurt.
Down at the 46-yard line. And that looked like
every
some
time,
pretty
like,
easy yardage there,
like,
right
go
up the
down
gut.
And he's a guy that has some
like,
height
not,
to him,
even
so
not,
when you don't have to drop
like,
a shoulder
like a push
or create or get through contact
like
or trash,
it's not like a hard,
but
like
immediate
sack, but like just like a normal, you know, every day, you feel this every day, that sack. Like you train like this sack, but that kind of thing. I'm like, okay, you know, just get up
and
run.
Good.
And that's how you run the football and run it successfully. Big time
I get uneasy
picked up, but why?
When he
offensive
gets hit.
Lineman
like, if I scramble,
attack.
I would get really uneasy.
Than the
now, with my quarterback, well, I mean, with Philip Rivers, like, really
annoying. That's exactly
he's
what
he's
happened
an
old
on
dude.
That
play. The
but with,
front,
like, my main quarterback,
result,
like, regular,
a
which I haven't played in a while.
That was a nice run. Slice make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route. And then breaks it off usually after about 3 to 4
I'm
steps,
going to
and cuts towards the middle of the
like
field.
I always
and
get like
he's trying to do
I always get
his body to keep
like,
the defender away from the football
get up,
and
get
the quarterback
up,
a really nice target. Everyone's got to be
up,
able to catch the football
up,
doesn't
up,
matter what position
up,
you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line.
At the 13 with a half.
Six and good
like,
enough
Adrian
to move
Peterson,
the chain.
He's an old dude.
Talk about
why does he think I'm
trading up the draft? Offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything.
Plugged in. Oh, there we go. Like Adrian Peterson, he's an old dude.
Sheet,
he's not the old, he's not the youngest
of
young people.
Of those.
He
he's
couldn't
an old dude.
Quite hold it. Got
oh,
hit.
He dropped it.
Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Yeah, and Philip Rivers is also an old dude. And so is
so
what's his
first.
Face? The other dude.
Trevor
Fitzgerald. My team is built to win now.
Here's Peterson.
It's not like the totally.
So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Kind of like
down.
The total opposite of the Panthers.
Well, there
built
they went blitz defensively, Charles, and things were paved well coming from the linebacker position.
I love the way that you described it, paved well. Oftentimes, the guy who gets home on the blitz, he's going to get all the credit. But his teammates did all the dirty work, right? They ran into people on purpose.
Oh, they were just running around.
They sometimes tugged on jerseys to hold linemen to create space and gaps. And that play finished off really, really well. Well-conceived, well-designed, and even better executed.
Looks like the offense is going to take another shot here. They're going on 4th and 13. Rivers to throw it. And it is incomplete.
He didn't even catch the football.
It looked like he had it and dropped it. And the...
I mean, I don't really care if he got the first down. I mean, he dropped the football. Let's see what they can put together. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And on the last drive,
they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it. Didn't get it. How does that change
colorblind
the mentality?
It's so bad. For you. I don't think you're like watching my video and you're colorblind. You're like, who's who?
I mean, he likes touchdowns, not field goals. You got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit if they're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see.
There he goes. You can tell from the circle that it's me. It's like newness.
Justin Hunter, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Bucs have taken
my bad, my
lead.
Since he caught that one and scored it, I gotta tell the story before the game, that's number 24, bad man.
Dropped one, it bounced up and just hit me right in the gut. And I said, come on, man, but there, there was no drop.
Yeah, you okay now?
I'm good. It's back on the field here. Let's see what they can do on this play. And Tampa Bay trots out there now.
Our score is like, let's see if they can do just that. You get oh, they had a deflection. You get to submit your own pictures, and because, like, we're having a yearbook.
This one up close to about
the goal, like,
give him a couple on the carry there.
Because you gotta have
it in
the yearbook. The goal for them is to get every student in the yearbook 3 times.
Rivers now on
me
second down.
Being the unpopular kid that I am!
Oh, you saw that one.
Literally,
it's
up there and went,
oh, back across his body. A great read, and it's picked off.
Because then I'm in the yearbook. Then the other half of me went, like, Hunter, where is it? So is every other kid in the
school. Let's see what this offense
and in my mind,
in
my other part of my mind, went,
now the Buccaneer offense set to take over again. And following
and the
interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or maybe just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still on attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Brandon Flowers. And he'll return this ball across midfield.
Ours is brighter
than this. 47-yard line.
And... oh, I think he just got picked too.
Back out there now. Let's see what they can put together. The Buccaneers getting ready to go as they take the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college.
Now a hit, and Rivers lost the football. And this is going to be brought back. It's a scoop and score for the Falcon TD. And give some kudos to the defense. Back on the field here. Let's see what they can do on this play. And now the Buccaneers offense gets set to head back onto the field. From the shotgun, it's Rivers.
If I was dying, if I was playing. If I was, then I'm not. But if I was dying, I'd be like, okay. I'm dying. And then you'd be all sad and start crying,
left,
and I'd be
two
like,
to the right.
Oh, no, I still make videos
on second down,
I'm
Rivers again.
Dead.
He's going to loft one deep.
Oh,
this is taken
in.
It's complete. The 20.
No,
10.
No, no. Shake it off. Shake him off. Shake him off.
His 6th touchdown of the season.
I call it comeback.
Get the quick strike touchdown.
Don't call it comeback. big.
And they just ran the fly route there, didn't they?
Look at this. He just got him quickly. He has a safety. He just literally drops in on the safety. The ball literally drops over the safety stick. He just didn't go at it. He keeps it good.
Speed.
Speed.
And he shakes.
Speed. And what does it do?
It kills.
There you go.
I just want to watch that replay, though. Hey, man. Oh, no. Nope. We're slow down by 10.
Let's see what this offense can do here on this
play. Oh, wait.
And Tampa Bay
trots
out there now. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
Rivers. And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off.
I'm going
to third.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion, and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
One receiver left, three to the right. Now Rivers. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And this one is incomplete. Apparently very brief in his report. Thanks anyway, my man. It's we're already set for action.
Okay, now after this, I'm gonna need my defense.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the
Buccaneers,
they'll have it first to start in the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made
if they
in that locker room.
Okay.
And I never wanted to make create more hype than what is there. But this
you're
is
gonna
a
do that?
I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Throwing Rivers.
And what the
heck? Picked off by the linebacker Carlos Dansby. And he's able to get it back to
the jersey, man. It's the jersey.
Fits back out there now. Let's see what they can put together. And Tampa Bay
I can't
trots
see anything
out there.
Now. Okay, you got Matthews. Oh, I should have my Spencer out there. I don't even know what his name is.
They come out here in the eye. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He's going to loft one. Deep left. It's caught.
Larry.
Inside the 25.
It's two, boy.
Time for Tampa Bay. 52 yards. Fresh set of downs here. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply.
Okay.
If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the
Come
field. You still
on.
Carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball.
Yeah, that running
I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory?
Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough third and 12.
Oh, here comes some interceptions.
And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary now.
And I'm not really
third.
That great on tip.
Here's Rivers.
Even though I've got like 16 of them. Oh!
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by the linebacker, Paul Posluszny.
I lost him. I totally lost him. He like when he ran across, he like you know when like a color runs across another color.
Like
I don't know. I don't remember what the like there was like an optical term for it. We learned it when we like learned about like a bunch of optical leads. But kind of like
you can't get that back. Let's get back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going
to
say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the best.
I like that even better.
Man, he'll be brought down
like,
just shy of midfield.
Another color splashes along another color, and you don't even, sometimes you don't even see, like, one of the colors.
And,
like,
this is,
like,
game,
like
they can run
which
that
really,
plan
I don't think
down.
It happens in, like, a video game, because it's, like, manipulated colors. But I mean, bro, you mind? Oh, come on.
He's got the rookie from Arkansas, Hunter Henry. 23 yards on the play. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They'll give it to him right up the gut.
No way!
Ran right through the trash.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. Second down following the run. To throw is Rivers. That is caught at the seven. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5 yard line. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucks may have moved.
Offense.
Use the snap count to move the defense.
Rivers on first down. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Larry Fitzgerald.
So now we're down by. Action.
Let's see what this offense can do here on this play. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up? Now go to the ground game. And now
oh, my.
Another interception. Picked off by Brandon Flowers. And his crew will take over. The offense back out there now. Let's see what they can put together.
Like
now the
six,
Buccaneers
seven,
offensive unit back seven. Out on the field. And last time wasn't pretty. Hey. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first drive. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. And they went big on first down. Proves unfruitful. So second and 10
five
here.
You just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
And in comes right there. The a nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Defense has set themselves up nicely. Third and 10 now. To throw, Rivers. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. A gain of 3, second down. On play action, Rivers. And this one caught by Hunter over the middle. A very solid gain of 27. And quickly, they get to the line. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. And on the ground they go with the running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Second down, Rivers.
And
the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes.
But I mean, literally, you
David
helped
King
so much.
Keep
me down so that way now we're about 20 yards back.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go.
Thanks
on
a lot,
down.
You idiots.
Third and long for Rivers. He's going to let it fly. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And he's in.
Boom.
The end zone.
Four verticals.
Touchdown.
Give it to that guy. Interceptions. can. I'm like, wow. Gonna be the worst. Oh man. That was 4-4. Oh wow, nothing? About this season, it's the relocation I care about. So far, I mean, 8 games or 4-4. It's the younger team I'm excited about. I mean, the picks I drafted up for, I'm going to go back through and trade up picks. I think they auto scout for you too. I don't know. Right as it says 17, I'm gonna stop. I hope it doesn't automatically answer the question. Canceling it? The heck? Why didn't it cancel 17? Oh, it's like Peterson got her. Oh, Apple Blue got her, apparently. Yep, so we're playing there. I really hope it didn't auto-negotiate contracts. I think it did. I think it did auto-negotiate. Nine and seven. No way. Oh, wait. I thought we were all in. Oh, did I pass it? Maybe. You were not even make the playoffs from the game. Wow, the 49ers beat us out because they won one more game than us. That strikes my heart right there. Oh, that strikes my heart deep. Since the offseason. Let's go ahead. Wow, that strikes me in my feels right there. Right in the feels. Oh, we almost, 3 other losses. We won 500 games. Are we 9-7? The manager, the coach did. He did moderately good. He did moderately amazing. Moderately.
This is the last opportunity to resign your players, or they will become free agents.
Okay, so now I have time to negotiate. Wait, David Johnson.
Oh, he's a fullback. Okay, definitely. Couple years and some moolah. He's pretty good smash. I get that. I already got like two interceptions. Oh! Just not interested in signing with me. Well, I don't appreciate that. Thank you. Nah. 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 You I'm gonna take though. Because you're good words. Okay, now we're in the off season. Okay, so now we're officially the Monarchs. Wow. Sign free agents. Okay, let's look at new available free agents. Okay, available. Hold on, hold on. Mason Crosby. Top 100. Oh wow. I already have a good. Ooh. Going 2 mil and 4 mil. Oh, crazy. I don't know what that stuff is, but I'm just gonna make it. Ish. I don't even know what that means. And next week, I believe, has the combine results. Next week,
all combine stats such as the 40-yard dash are now available in scouting. Check it out.
Really? Okay. Rejected. Ew.
Each player now has a combine grade. This score represents how well this player did in the combine. Combine performance tells you how his speed, jumping, acceleration, agility, and strength compares to their skill position.
Let me go to my watch. I want my watch first. Okay. So, left end, the dude that I really like, that I'm really looking at. He did really good. He got a 7.2 grade, which I like. 20-yard shuttle. That's gonna be good. Broad jump. I'm not really looking at his jump though. I mean, that's good. His 40-yard dash, it's still good. He's got the 20-yard shuttle though. The 3-cone bench press. Not as strong as I would have hoped. I got this red zone threat. Here. He didn't really star in anything, which I'm not particularly amazing. Let me look at my picks. First, 20th, 25th, 20th, 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 20th. Okay. So I'm not gonna get
I'm the first number one pick in the draft, though. You know what? We're trades. Trading up for some more picks. Trade center. Manual trade. I want picks, and I cannot lie. All you other brothers can't deny. What do they need? They want okay. Left outside linebacker. I'll just grab one of the draft. Never mind. I won't even need one. Unless I trade him and then I'll give him a pick. Is that what they want? They want that in the pick? Huh? Is that what I want? Is that what you want? What you want? What you want? Let's see what they want. They want. They're interested in him. Even though their interest levels are high, they're interested in him. There you go. Nope, won't go. I don't know what else to give you. Okay? I don't. What else do you want? I want that pick. Still does matter though. Yes! I'm basically upgrading my pick to pick 6. Okay. Now I feel like smart.
Oh, this is what a bad combo. Ooh, 7.4 combo. 5.4. I'm taking most hot watches. Oh wow, 4.0. 4.8. Hey. Oh, I like that 7.5 combo. I think he might be a skirt. He's gonna be a skirt. First, 6th, 20th. And then another 20th in the next round. So on, so forth. 7.3 combo. let's go ahead. Let's see what kind of. I'm gonna do this later. 7.3. I don't really need outside linebackers. I think my linebackers are. Okay, you know what? I believe it's time for the. I believe it is time for the London Monarchs to draft their NFL new. Or their. Oh, he accepted an offer. It's time for the London Monarchs. Okay. Holes, wide receiver. Holes. Defense. Linebackers. Remember, right. Linebackers and stuff. Alright, sure. I'm not gonna do any last seconds. I'm going to the draft. Alright, let's do this. We got round one, pick one. Alright, this is
welcome
something
to
that.
Draft week. All the effort you spend scouting comes down to this. Start the draft when you're ready.
London Monarchs are now on the clock.
Oh, wait. What? There's an offer? Oh. They want to give us the round one, pick three. They'll give us the picks. Wait, okay, so if I give them the round one, they'll give me a round. Wow, oh, that's a different. That's an offer. It's an offer I can refuse, though. It's giving up maybe a chance at greatness. You know what? I'm gonna take it.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a trade. The Jaguars are after who's got more on this pick.
I heard he surprised several scouts at his pro day when he showed up looking a lot leaner. And the difference showed when he went through drills. He turned in slightly faster times than expected in every major drill and displayed improved footwork compared to how he looked at the tail end of the season. I've heard from a few different coaches that they'd like to see him put some weight back on, yet keep playing as quick as he currently is. Whether he does that or not, I think we'll see him on the line on Sundays.
Okay, so pick 18, pick 4, pick 36. Okay, so I've got a few picks. Okay, pick 19, pick 21, pick 51. Pick 16, pick 10, pick 80, pick 25. None of these are good. I'm declining all offers. Declining all offers. Make my selection. Yeah, I want to pick. Okay, wow. Watch list. Okay, watched. Okay. Quick combat grade. Combine grade, not combat grade. Should I go for the red zone threat? Should I go for the rusher?
All right, team is now off the clock. Adam Schefter, can you tell us about their newest player?
He's been the subject of a fair amount of controversy after a mediocre season.
Overall,
that culminated with one of the most impressive final games our defensive lineman has ever enjoyed. Critics claim he was the beneficiary of a tired offensive line, while his proponents cite an incredible swim and rip move that complement a powerful bull rush as the recipe to his success. If he struggles in the NFL and proves his critics right, it'll be interesting to see how much patience his new team has to watch him develop before moving in a different direction.
Oh, I still have combat for a second? We still have combat? Do I still have 4 seconds? Oh, no, wait. Gosh. I'm focusing on a lot of different players. And... 7.2 combat rating. B-Temple. But can he play left outside linebacker? I need him to play left outside linebacker. Or should I go with the middle? Yeah, but I have better chance of the middle.
The Cowboys are now on the clock.
Ooh, 77.
Now that the pick's in, let's go to Adam. Adam, what can you tell us about this guy?
It's always great to see a running back win the Heisman. It's like a sign that the old ways of ground and pound haven't completely vanished. He was a pure workhorse for the team and accounted for well over 60% of its total offensive production. Remove him from the team, and I strongly believe it wouldn't have finished at the top of its conference. And now he has the chance to carry the ball at the next level, and this team just got a gem of a player. We'll see if he becomes its primary ball carrier right from the start, or if it incorporates him into a running back by committee system.
Oh, wow.
System.
I'll split. Okay. So most of my players are down. I got red zone threat down there. Wait, let me go to my... Oh, I can't even... Can I look at my team? Secretary, okay. Let me go... Oh, yeah, I was looking at... Tackles, guards, okay. That's a rush. This is a guard, right? And then go left guard. Okay, so right guard and left guard are covered. So, good. Oh, I got 90 seconds. Okay. Watch. Oh, we're moving it again. Okay, guard. I don't remember. Come on, this is very hard. I don't know what to do. Go wide receiver. Just
the
player.
Texans are now on the clock.
76. That was a stupid idea. Undraft makes you should pick.
The London Monarchs are now on the clock.
Okay. Final offense because I'm not trading off this pick. Player, okay. Is he still in there? Watched. No. Oh, karma. He had a good combat grade. I'm taking him based on his combat grade. Or combine. What?
Our very own Adam Schefter has more to say about this pick.
In a surprise move during the season, he left the team, citing personal reasons for the decision. From some of the reports I've heard, it sounds like he had some family issues that he really wanted to settle before the draft. His coach and teammates didn't hold any ill will against him and actually seemed supportive in his decisions. He mentioned to several teams during the combine interviews that he felt a burden lifted off his shoulders, and now he can really focus on football. Despite missing a lot of his senior year, I like this kid a lot, and I think he'll do fine for this team.
Okay, now let's go ahead. Okay, so...
basically picking on combat. I called it right, yes. Okay. Cornerback. Looks like he had a good combine grade. If only I could spend my points. Oh, wow.
The Texans are now on the clock.
Oh, my. That was a bad idea. I'm trying to go. Okay, you know what? Let's just...
Fixed and made, let's go to Adam Schefter to hear more about the player.
Scouts I've talked to expressed a great deal of frustration with his inconsistent play throughout this...
Yeah, shut up, Adam Schefter. Excuse me, adjust roster. Okay, so let's look at you know how any sacks last year? How about this? Every game. Okay, here we go. So, had 113 passer rating, 3,000 yards, man. 33 passing touchdowns, 12 picks, 12 interceptions. Longest pass was 89 yards, which I think might have been. Sacked 20 times, 237 pass completions, my bad. 64% completion percentage. Average yards per game. 200%. Did he not win MVP? Who didn't vote him MVP though? That's what I'm wondering. Backup powers. Oh, I finally got this dude. This is the rookie, isn't he? Yeah. The rookie middle linebacker also playing. Oh, wow. was apparently quick. Oh, did he let... Wait, did the computer let go of me? Oh, that's sad. The computer let go of, what's his face? Of, I mean, Madame Third. That'd make a lot more sense. Oh, did they move? Oh, no, he's over here. Oh, that's left there. Wait. Huh? Oh, is it going from the other side, though? Oh, goodness. Got the door. Oh, maybe it's going from the other side, though. See how happy our fans are. They have one of the best games of me. Looks like owner. Market size. Well, I mean, I got the whole UK on my side. Look at the little comment. The fans love our ticket prices right now. And look at her face. The fans love our ticket prices right now. See, I like we're trying to like keep secret. Okay. So, let's go ahead. Oh, I don't want to sim 10 years, buddy. Calm down. I just wanted to sim past the preseason. But apparently, I definitely love them. I'm only sim 10 years, which that would take a while. Unless it's just like, kind of just like, war field. The amount of travel, though. I'm just looking forward to the first regular season game. In Parliament State. Wow. Parliament State. I'm hoping they like acknowledge that. Like, you know? Like, I've never gone past even a season in owner mode in this game. So I mean that's why I was so eager to sim the season, because I was like, practice would have been here. Look at this offense. Look at this. 54 overall due to backup. Oh, now he's 84 overall. Oh, it's probably because his confidence was down. He was like really good. He was like 86 or 87. You wanna go?
games. I'm not watching anything. I'm about to play my first game in Parliament Stadium in London.
What? That's crazy.
Yep.
I'm going to the Dollar Tree.
Okay, grab ice cream. Why did he drop so low? Yo, Bankston. You get the injury report? You got injured last week. Come on, Yanda. 4 weeks, too. Bonus of 1.9, getting 3.5. Is that, you're expecting that? Oh, okay, why were you expecting that offer? I only gave you that offer because you've been in the game, okay? Look, it's not working. Could do that. Oh, we're 72 overall. Okay. Oh, we don't even have a color. Okay, so our team's a lot. 79 overall now. He got 13 catches and 2. Wow. Bankston's doing good. Bankston's like my, kind of like my, you know, rookie buddy. I'm trying to shape this team, like, now my goal, trade up for the number one overall pick again. Get, like, a top 3 overall pick. And then, draft the quarterback. You heard me right, draft the quarterback. That I can use when Rivers dies. Rivers is gonna retire.
Hello, everyone.
International series.
All right, the offense back on the field here. Let's see what they can do on this play.
International series. Well, I'll let you know, this ain't no international series. It's an actual game in London. Okay, look at all the people that turned off. That turned out for this amazing London game, okay?
And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second
down.
They're
London Monarchs, okay? Not for some international series game, but for the London Monarchs.
Johnson with a completion over the middle. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup. And just
vertical
like that, it's third down.
That's going to be a vertical.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But doesn't matter what you call the position.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he does take it in for the touchdown, but
that's called a rookie right there.
And I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
Decline.
After a nice game, they don't need the penalty. They'll decline it, take the ball where the play resulted.
In the touchdown. Ross's first career touchdown at home. Oh, good.
First trip to the end zone, and I think it's safe to say one he'll always
remember.
Oh, without a doubt, that one is going to be imprinted forever. And nowadays, we're seeing rookies make a greater impact at that position at receiver than ever before.
Wow.
I think mainly because of the sheer volume of footballs that they catch in college. When you're in man coverage and a receiver runs a slant route, every bit of you gets tested.
That was a vertical play. Your ability to react, your agility, and footwork, because it's so fast.
They're just trying to get the ball out of the hands of the quarterback and to the receiver
touchdown.
As fast as possible.
It's caught inside the
25.
Touchdown! Rashad Perriman.
We got vertical plays, baby.
These guys get the quick strike touchdown.
This is for you, one kicker. This is for you.
What offense can do here on this play? So out now comes the offense back onto the field, and they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously,
Jump.
They'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back?
Outside.
Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
Let's see if they dial it up this drive. Oh, look at that.
Oh, look at him turn.
And a nice gain of 21 yards.
I see. That's kind of
weird. All right,
now
got to be careful here. All right, he's on the plus side of 30. There may be a little gray in the beard, but that's not slowing down his speed as far as he's concerned.
Wait, he's saying I'm on the plus side
of
30.
Well, you're on the plus side of 30. You all know what I'm on the plus
side
of. All I know is that run right there. Let us know there's
still some
life in those legs.
Absolutely, still got a lot of life.
I mean, we're in London, so we're kind of in
the corner, Jimmy Smith.
But we're really, like, we're far.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two, now third down.
I give a lot of thanks that my DNA did not make me an offensive tackle. Because that is a very difficult job to hold your block against a really good defensive end and hang on to it so your runner can get to the edge and do it without holding. I don't know that that's
down?
Really possible for very many people.
That was a pretty good throw on the curl route there, third down, and they pick up a first.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
They should be aware, but it was so hard sometimes. Because when they sell that route really well, you think they're going upfield, then they curl back,
show the numbers
to the quarterback, and complete the play.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It's a gain of 14 there. That'll give them a first down.
I didn't even know it
really
had, like,
a solid run right there. It had those little wide receiver set.
On
if you're offensive coordinator,
lines, it had,
used to
like,
tell people,
I didn't even know it had that.
Now they use four receivers on the field to spread things out, give them more running lanes and more options. And also,
thanks,
usually go. Takes the bigger defenders
thanks,
off the field.
My
makes
boy.
The defense lighter and easier to run against. This offense is in rhythm now, just accumulating first downs and moving the ball downfield.
They'll run with Peterson. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Rivers now on second down. And that'll be incomplete.
That's blocking on the defense, sir.
This defense has held on so far. Now from the 3, this is third and goal.
Now I'm walking by my...
Hey, Delta!
Check.
380!
Watch it now, Barney! Back!
Third and goal for Rivers.
No!
Blitz coming in, down he goes. Malcolm Smith coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. Field goal forthcoming for Steven Hauschka. Well, this has been a pretty sizable
drive.
I knew that. Finally, the defensive coordinator found some success. I think he just simply said enough of that.
We need to force the issue from our end, and that's exactly what he did.
So 3 points is the outcome, but probably not what they're looking for given the drive that they were on.
Yeah, things were
17-6. 17-6.
All right, the offense back out My there now. Let's see what they can put together. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal,
Larry. Also, it's first target. Isn't it?
Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they get the.
Wow.
Back on the field here. Let's see what they can do on this play. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your...
And that's caught inside the 35. A big play there just before halftime. 43 yards. The last drive, he threw the pick, but... He's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know, there's a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw five and still find a way to win the game in the end.
This throw caught right around the six. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. Final play of the half, Rivers. That's caught at the two.
No.
And he's able to get it down to the 2 yard line. So we. Okay, well, so much for the halftime report here. Guy can't even finish his Snickers. We're going to get right to the third quarter. Let me spit this out. This will be taken to the back of the end zone.
This is my first time actually, like, returning it.
And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
That was my first time, like, you know, actually returning it. Well, I don't think they have to do that, because everybody, like, picks up the back of it.
Now this offense ready to take over again. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook.
Oh!
What they did in the first half, that worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. And he'll get this one up to the 26. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a third and three. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock, and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock. When any pass is in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
On fourth down, they snap it to Rivers. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Boy, a curious Let's see what this offense can do here on this play. And now back out comes the offense. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Oh, he's double
it. It caused every bit of...
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted.
Is that even
enough
to catch the ball, or is that enough to block him from catching the ball?
Back out there now. Let's see what they can put together. Now this offensive unit ready to see what they can do here. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And got his man complete. And he's brought down after a good game. 26 yards on the pickup there. And that'll be good enough for the first. And now they're in the hurry up. A first down throw here for Rivers. And incomplete, he dropped it.
I know he's a
rookie mistake there. Second down.
Doesn't have the best
and this is a guy straight out of college. They're not going to try to groom for a year or two. They want him to produce right away.
That's why they took him in the first round. They expect him to be a starter right away and a future all-pro. So they don't have any time to wait for him to come along. They want him to play right now to help this team.
Really, it's a solid draft class from a year ago. They were able to address some key weak spots on their team and fill in some holes.
And they were able to identify the players they wanted early in the process. Got a little bit of luck, as some guys may have fallen to them. But for the most part, knew their philosophy and stuck to it.
Here's Rivers. Hits his target, Hunter. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. And they're going to speed things up here. Rivers now to throw on first down. He's going to go for a big play downfield. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
That's a bold strike right there, taking it downfield and putting some air on it. But how about the coverage? Able to get his hands across the receiver and bat the ball down.
On second down, Rivers again. He's going to take another shot here. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. A great read, and it's picked off.
Kicked.
And a big turnover there. The offense back on the field here. Let's see what they can do on this play.
They turned it off.
Throwing the interception here, Rivers. He's going to go up top again. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
I thought I was supposed to have a boost. I would boost every play I did.
I like the bonus, and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered. He was able to get a hand in and knock it away.
Throw a little bit off guard.
They'll give it to him right off the gun. And he'll take this one up over the 20 to the 21-yard line. It'll be a pickup of five, and that leaves him with five more. Third and five now. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. A 10th carry now for Peterson.
Yeah. What are you doing?
Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Desperation time. Rivers on fourth down. And no, it's incomplete. The fourth down pass play doesn't work out. And the Vikings. Back to live action. Let's see what this offense can do here on this play. And here now the offense heading back out there. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
How many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah. And recover.
The defense has to really, like...
They come out with one back and three tight ends.
He
takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
We just saw another example of really good defensive football, which has led to the cushion that they have in this game. Got to him once again, knocked him on the ground, forced an incompletion.
And it set the tone. It's one thing to set the tone, another to come in here on the road and set the tone. Throwing again, Rivers on second and 10. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
He would have caught that.
They decided to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
And the Vikings with an extra defender in the secondary on third.
Playing coverage here.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact.
Where is he?
Incomplete.
Larry's getting old. Larry, you're getting old, man. You're getting old.
So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. Dennis is
where did
incomplete.
He come from?
They had to go
that's
for it with such a long time remaining. And the Vikings,
the
they have the football. Offense back out there now. Let's see what they can put together. So out now comes the offense back onto the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once we were down huge.
Now Rivers lost the football. Well, call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. They don't care if it was luck or skill. Boy, the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball...
He's got a man complete. 20, 10. Touchdown.
I just wasted a bunch.
Sean Perriman, 85 yards. That is got...
And now a little bit of a loop. I can't believe I just lost that game. Wow, that sucked. My offense isn't what it was. Larry Fitzgerald. Larry, though! Did he even catch a ball? I think he caught like two balls. I want him like immediately. How do I get him? I want him. First round, get pick. I like idea. Not good. So I got that QB. Basically guaranteed because I got any pick that I want. Hackenberg, gonna work out good. Clemens. Let's go to Trick Town. Let's see if there's anybody who maybe needs a quarterback. And a Q. gonna come up with the future goal that I got. I'm just gonna fix this and just put that next time. Okay, but I'm looking for one. Like, there was desired. Ha! 16. I like that offer. Hackbird. Actually, no. Let's go with Clements. And then, what else do they need? Right end? They're gonna get a right end. Gilbert. And they need a right guard. They're gonna get a right guard. Gun is right good. You like this? Not even a little bit. You know what? I traded the second for that one, fourth, the third, and fourth. I can't already pick the fourth. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, how about that? Yeah. I like that. Nope, you don't. I can't work. Should I trade? I'm not gonna trade with this. You know what? That's gonna be it for today, guys. I hope you guys did enjoy watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment about the questions for my little video I'm gonna put up. Okay, so I have to do a baseball stream. Baseball. Oh god, I believe. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to smash that like button. And yeah, stay cool. Peace.